Well, right now we're being joined by Reverend Lowell Grisham of St. Paul's Episcopal Church in Fayetteville, because Lowell, today you're hosting a speaker that really, in all fairness, is considered a controversial one. And so we wanted to talk to you about why it was your decision to bring him here. So tell us about what's going on today.
We have invited retired Bishop of New Hampshire, Gene Robinson, who is the first openly gay bishop in the Episcopal Church, and as far as I know, in the Anglican Communion. And he's been a part of a story, not just in our church, but in a lot of churches over the last decade or so, about the place of GLBT people in our congregations.
And you said this is something your congregation has supported for a long time, many years, you said.
Well, not long after Gene's election, our congregation entered into a conversation period, a period of discernment and prayer, asking whether we would like to offer blessings to gay couples who are in committed relationships in our congregation. And after about a year's process of study, of prayer, and of conversation, we decided that, yes, we would like to offer those blessings, and have done so.
And now I know you told me last night that Gene was actually in a little bit early and met with some of your congregation last night. What are some of the questions they're asking them? How supportive are they?
Well, a lot of the questions came out of our screening of the documentary about his life. And so one of the questions had to do with the times that his life has been threatened. There was a time when he was coming back to his home when the police just happened to stop a fellow who had shot the windows out of a police car, or maybe a car parked. And they found inside Gene's picture, Gene's spouse's picture, his partner Mark, and a map to their home, which is in a rural setting with lots of windows in New Hampshire.
So it appears he was the target.
It looks like he was the intended target.
Wow.
When Gene was ordained, he had a bulletproof vest underneath him because of so many death threats. So he's lived with that. There were questions about that.
Right, absolutely. I think a lot of people here in our area would probably have some questions about this too. So remind us again where we can go to see him. That is going to be at your church tonight?
That's right. Tonight we'll have a reception at 6 o'clock by our famous St. Spatula's Guild, and then he'll speak his keynote address at 7 and Sunday morning at 10 o'clock.
All right, and that is St. Paul's Episcopal Church in Fayetteville.
That's right. Thank you. Parking lot's right across from the courthouse.
Thank you so much, Reverend.